Oceans are fascinating places. They make up over 70% of Earth's surface area and are home to some of the strangest and most unique organisms. How can one explain the presence of transparent jellyfish and sharks whose backs and ventral regions are different colors? Why are some organisms near the seafloor jet black? And why do tuna have reflective scales? Camouflaging, also known as cryptic coloration, is a trait displayed in almost all species alive today. Organisms use camouflage to mask their location, identity, and movement, which allows them to avoid predators and sneak up on prey by blending into their environment. Camouflaging on land is relatively straightforward. Most animals display earthy tones so that they blend into their surroundings. This is known as concealing coloration or background matching. But what about aquatic life? How do organisms camouflage in oceans, where light falls from above and there is no visible background and almost no color variation? This question has been pondered for centuries. In fact, Aristotle in ancient Greece commented on the color-changing abilities of cephalopods, including the octopus, in his Historia Animalium. We would later discover these to be microscopic pigments called biochromes that allow the octopus's skin to change color, pattern, and opacity. Today, we've identified three main camouflage methods that dominate the world's oceans: transparency, reflection, and counterillumination. To explore these methods and see them in action, let's take a dive into the depths and see what we find. Near the surface waters, at about 100 meters depth, transparency and reflectivity are the most apparent. Many marine animals that float near the surface, such as plankton, jellyfish, and salps, are highly transparent, giving them almost perfect camouflage in bright surface waters from all angles. These organisms have gelatinous bodies that are composed mainly of water. Their thick mesoglia is acellular and highly transparent, which allows some gelatinous planktonic animals to be between 50 and 90% transparent. We also notice lots of highly reflective fish. Sardine and herring, which are covered with highly reflective scales, give the appearance of silvered mirror glass. At medium depths at sea, light comes from above, so a mirror oriented vertically makes animals appear almost invisible from the side. That explains why we see so many transparent and reflective organisms. Let's continue our journey and head towards the depths. As we dive deeper to 100 and 1,000 meter depths, we notice something unique. Counterillumination and countershading are becoming the main methods of camouflage. Counterillumination through bioluminescence on the ventral region of the body is created by photophores, which are light-producing organs that create a glow and prevent animals from appearing as dark shapes when seen from below. Countershading, which is slightly different from counterillumination, is common in fish, including sharks, marlin, and mackerel, and animals such as dolphins and penguins. They are darker on the top and lighter on the bottom, which allows them to blend in with the dark ocean below when looked at from above, and match the bright surface waters when looked at from below. So now that we know why sharks have different colors on their front and back, let's dive deeper and explore the benthic province. There are many other types of camouflage in the oceans near the seafloor. Mimesis is practiced by animals such as the leafy dragon, which resemble parts of plants and gently rock their bodies as if swayed by a current. Self-decoration is when animals use materials from their environment to camouflage themselves. Sea urchins use their 2 feet to pick up shells, rocks, and algae, and sometimes sea anemones, from the bottom and attach it to their upper surfaces. Disruption outlines used by fish, such as humbug damselfish, have bold disruptive patterns on their sides, breaking up their outlines with strong contrasts. These have the effect of destroying the signature fish outline of these animals. Adaptive coloration is another common method of camouflage near the seafloor. Bottom living fish, such as the flounder, can hide themselves against a variety of backgrounds through their ability to change color rapidly. Many cephalopods, including the octopus and squid, similarly use color change. In the deep sea, where very little sunlight filters down, ultra-blackness is achieved with a thin but continuous layer of particles in the dermis called melanosomes. Predators may use bioluminescence to illuminate prey by detecting them by the light they reflect. Some deep-sea fish have a skin so extremely black that it reflects less than 0.5% of the light that falls on it. These fish are separate species and demonstrate that natural selection has driven the convergent evolution of ultra-blackness camouflage independently many times. Although we have reached the end of our journey for now, we can still view these incredible camouflage mechanisms being used in the evolution of technology. Since its origins in the Second World War, studies in counter-illumination were tested on Canadian Navy corvettes. Because skies are bright, an unilluminated aircraft may be rendered visible. By emitting a small amount of blue light, the aircraft's brightness better matches the sky, and the aircraft is able to fly closer to its target before being detected. In robotics, professors at the Marine Biological Laboratory in Woods Hole, Massachusetts, are collaborating with bioengineers to develop a material that mimics the camouflage mechanism of cuttlefish and squid. The material might be able to hide objects or keep buildings cool in the summer and warm in the winter by darkening their exteriors to absorb heat and lighting them to reflect it. At the BioRobotics Institute at San Anna School of Advanced Studies in Italy, researchers are creating a synthetic form of cephalopod skin that can transform a flat, 2D surface to a three-dimensional one with bumps and pits. This technology may be used to hide and be protected from animal attacks, as well as better approach animals for studying them in their natural habitats. The real-world applications of cryptic coloration are nearly endless. From advancing the frontiers of medicine by modeling human conditions such as albinism, to advancing robotic technology, it is clear that camouflage, although used by organisms to stay hidden, has shown us a world of unthinkable possibilities.